What's up, my name is Jared, and in today's video we're going to look at 30 commands that you can use to make you a better, smarter engineer. Let's have a look. The first command we are going to look at is hostname. This will actually display the name of the computer that you're actually working on. If you need more information about the system, you can enter the system info command. This will output lots of information like the OS name, the hardware, the hotfixes, the amount of RAM. It has literally every piece of information that you will actually need. The next command you can enter is task list. This will actually list out all of the tasks and processes that are currently running on your machine. If one of those tasks is hanging or you want to close one, the easiest way to do it is to type in task kill and dash PID for the process ID and then enter the number. For example, Chrome here will be 11996, and you would just hit enter to close Chrome. The next command you can enter is file comparison. This is something that I use quite a lot actually for like network configs. I've created two files so I can show you how it works. You just type in FC/C and then you type in the name of the first file and then the name of the second file. You hit enter and then it will actually output the differences between the two files. The next command is CLS for clear screen. This just cleans the text within the command prompt. Next command you can enter is vir, so that will output the system version number. So this is the build number of your operating system. So for some group policy commands, you can enter gp update, and that will actually go and pull down the latest group policy from the user and computer. If for some reason this is taking a long time or it's failing or it's really lagging, you can do gp update. Force, that will forcibly pull down the latest group policy for the user and the computer. One of my favorite commands is, especially when working with the group policy, is the GP result. This will actually output the results of your group policy update to a HTML file. And then you can open it up and you can actually view the group policy and you can see which policies are actually being applied to the computer and the user. Let's just open that one up so we can have a look. So you can see here it's automatically created this report. If this was on a computer that was domain joined, then it would have a lot more information in it. So next we'll look at some network commands. Ping allows us to reach out to like a different host to see if it's actually available online. So if I go ping google.com, you can see it's actually gonna reply back with its IP address. So that basically means that it is online and it is replying. As you can see, it only sent 4 packets. If I want to do a continuous ping to a server or something, I can do ping, say for example, google.com, I'll do -t for continuous. That will continue pinging until I actually stop it. This is quite useful if you are working in a service desk position where you want to reboot a server or something. You can continuously ping it, reboot the server, and you could watch the server go down. And then you'd see the packets stopping, and then whenever it comes back up, you could see the packets starting to reply again. It just lets you know that the server is already on its way back up. Path ping is a good one. It will actually allow you to see the path it takes in order to get to that destination. So if I do path ping google.com again, you can see it's tracing the route it needs to take in order to get to that destination. Next one is IP config. This will output the IP address configuration for the actual machine itself. You can see here it's giving me my IP address, my subnet mask, and the default gateway. If you need more information on this machine, you can do ipconfig/all. This will then give you the IP addresses for all your adapters. You give the subnet mask, the default gateway, the DHCP server, the DNS. This gives you a lot more information. If you're having problems with your computer in terms of networking and you need to release that IP, you can simply type ipconfig/release. That will basically just get rid of the IP address that you already have. Then you would type ipconfig/renew to then reach out to the DHCP server then to ask for another IP address. If you wanted to look up the DNS cache on your machine, you could do ipconfig /display DNS. This will actually show you the cache, the DNS cache on your local machine. You can see that google.com has been resolved to this IP. If I was to look up, say, ping jerobrand.com, you can see now it's resolved the DNS name to this IP. And if I go back in here, type in ipconfig display DNS, you can see that this is also in this address now. This has also been captured. if you're having problems with DNS, you can completely delete them all by typing in ipconfig flush DNS. So that will get rid of all of the DNS that's in your cache. Next command is if you want to find the IP address of a host, like a server or a website or something, you can do nslookup. Nslookup jitterbrand.com. You can see that that DNS name has been resolved to this IP. If I needed to trace the route that the computer would need to take to get to jitterbrand.com, I could use the trace route command. jitterbrand.com. So this outputs the various hops that it has to take in order to get to that location. As you can see, the command above will actually resolve the DNS names to IP. If I wanted to run that again and just get the IP addresses, I could use the traceroute D. So the next command we can run is netstat. That will output all of the network statistics on your actual computer, so you can see all of the port numbers and whether connection is established or not. If you want to see all of the TCP and UDP connections, you could do netstat-af. If you want to go even further, you can see all of the connections that are active and listening, and also the process ID for the application as well. So you can do netstat-o. You can then correspond that process ID with the task list command that you learned earlier. The next really handy command that I've used millions of times is the route print. This will actually print out the routing table that the computer has. So if you look at this, you can see that the route here for the internet is the default route, which is the very top one. It's telling me that my default route out of the network is to point towards 192.168.0.1. I can also do a route add, and I can send, say for example, I want to do send 44.33.11. I want to route to that IP address via 0.56. That will then add that to the local routing table on this machine. And then if I do route print, I can actually see that that route has been added. If I wanted to delete that route, it's really easy. I just go route delete, and then I do the IP again, so 44.33.11. And then I go route print, and you can see that it's actually been deleted from the routing table. So another good one is ARP-A. So this will show you the ARP cache for the machine, and this is the mappings between the IP addresses and MAC addresses. The last command is getMAC. This will search your machine and then give you the MAC addresses for the network adapters on your computer. So whether it's the network port or wireless, it will give you them all. That's it. So that is 30 commands that will help you be a way better engineer. There's tons of commands out there, so I suggest if you're a help desk, Google them, learn them, they'll make your life so much easier. If you have any questions, then just drop them in the comment box below. If you really like the video, or you find it interesting at all, then please consider subscribing, and I will see you in the next one.